everyone, I'm Soumya. Welcome to Soumya's art channel. In this video, I'll be showing you the art of stone painting. So for this, I've chosen a simple subject, that is a grafted cacti. So let's see what's required to do a grafted cacti. Firstly, you need stone. So I've taken an elongated stone and I've taken a round stone. So basically, you will be placing the round stone over the elongated one like this. So two stones required for a cactus and a pot. I've filled the pot with stones already. So you'll be placing this stone like this. Next, you need acrylic paints. So I'm using Fevicryl acrylic paints. Then you will need brushes. I have taken a flat brush, round brush, and a pointed brush. Fevicryl molded clay or any air dry clay. Two bowls of water, one for washing and one for mixing colors. A waste cloth, a clean waste cloth to dry your brushes, and a plate to mix the paints. The stone that we have chosen is already pre-washed, clean, dry, with no residuals on it. This is very important because if in case there is any dust particles, the paint that is put on this will tend to fall off after it's being dried. So firstly, we'll give a coat of white paint for both the elongated and the round stone. The reason we need to give a coat of white paint is the colors that we put on top of this will be bright and rich. So give a very thin coat of white paint without any lumps and without any lines on it. Now both these stones are painted white. They are dry. So now we are going to apply the colors. So for the elongated one, I will use the sap green. And for the stout one, I will use crimson red. Now we'll apply the sap green for the elongated stone. Now I have painted, as you see, I have neatly painted with the red, crimson red, and sap green. So now we'll have to join both the small, the rounded stone on top of the green stone. So while it dries, we will use the molded Fevicryl molded clay. This has two parts, that is the resin base. The red wrappered one is a resin base and the blue wrappered one is a hardener. So we'll need to take both of it in equal proportion and mix it neatly. So I've taken equal proportion of the resin base and the hardener and mixing it neatly so that it gets to a unified light gray color. So as you see, it's neatly mixed now and ready to be used. Take a small pinch of this. We won't need much. Just this much would do. Ensure the stone and the paint is dry. Keep a small piece on top here like this. And mount this red pebble on top. Give it at least 10 to 15 minutes for it to completely dry and hold firmly to each other. So as you see, this is how it looks when they both are fixed to each other. Now if you can see, it's neatly dried, stuck to each other very tightly. So we can now start doing the painting for this, the details. For example, the elongated one, you can make it to have pattern along with thorns. I have taken parrot green, sap green, and white. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to mix white and parrot green to get a very light pale color, which I'm going to use for painting the thorns. So usually on the elongated cactus, the thorns are parallel to each other vertically up. I'll just mark some dots. I'm using a number two brush to mark these dots. So similarly, I will go ahead and mark dots parallelly throughout the elongated stone. As you see, I've completed putting the dots all round and they are dry. So now I will start painting the thorns. So for that, I'm using a very thin pointed brush. I'm using basically 000. With that, I will draw very thin spokes of lines around the dots that I have placed. See, this way. So likewise, we'll go ahead and paint the thorns. As you see, I have drawn these thin lines which look as thorns. Similarly, we'll have to do it for the upper part of the cactus which we have mounted here. So for that, I have chosen crimson red, for which I'll be adding just a bit of black, so it becomes maroon. So this is the one which I'm going to be using for putting the dots and the thorns. So I completed painting the red portion of the cactus, and now that the cactus is ready, we need to plant them into a pot. So I've taken a pot into which I'm going to mount this and give some decoration of white pebbles. I've painted a red beetle, so I'm going to place the red beetle here. So doesn't this look beautiful? So our cacti planters are ready. So hope you like it and will give it a try. I've done a few more other samples like expressions, angry bird, a fruit bowl, a big ladybug, a rabbit burrow, a bowl of vegetables in a giving it a cartoon look. This would look very beautiful for kitchen decor. Hope you all like this stone art and will give it a try. For more of my artworks, kindly refer to soumya.art. You can see the details in the description section on the procedure, the materials required, and my website. If you have liked it, give it a like, share, and subscribe.